This is the base of the same shrub what we saw just now. How I am handling the situation at the base. Now, portulaca is there growing here. That's a vegetable. And then, there's a small... there is a vidari. That is the giant potato. Now, all the extra water what I am pouring for the bitter gourd, she is also going to get a bit of it. And by the time they are all finished, this one will start climbing up. And then the mulch of Syzygium, because it's summer here and every day bitter gourd needs watering to trap the moisture and to keep the temperature cool, because this creates micro spaces in between where air gets trapped. It becomes a nice micro environment, and also the bottom layer starts decomposing. See, worms are there, earthworms are coming. So, not much of mulch, but steady application of mulch. Then you get a nice colored healthy vegetables on top, and it's quite disease free. At the bottom you can put some potato, sweet potato, any other root item like this vidari fits in well. And then a couple of these ground loving kind of a small edible herbs like mint can be planted here. And a little couple of beans can fit in very well. So with one watering source, one shrub, let's see the species now. This vitex, and then bitter gourd, and then the basal alba, and the string bean, and the vidari, that's a giant potato, and the portulaca, a couple of beans, amaranthus. See, there's amaranthus. So about 10 or 15 type of food items, and a couple of medicinal herbs also. That Amrita Bandi, the Tinospora alder, is climbing there.
There's Bala on the other end.
So about 15 species you can cover up by cleverly placing it up, one on the other, with each of them can coexist. And ants have made the nest, show that nest. See? So these ants never ever do the idiotic thing of destroying them, because they'll not make sure no insect comes and lands on this plant. Look at those soldiers. If I spray something on this plant now, they'll also die. Which is the dumbest thing anyone can do.